Sooners.
Now the Sooners with exactly 3.5 minutes to play in the game get the football first down at their own 16-yard line. Last time they had it, they fumbled it away. Lott pitches it outside. We've got an option play going here with Woodie Shepard. Throws it downfield. The pass is complete to Steve Rhodes, the wide receiver, the first Oklahoma pass of the day. And it's a first down at the Nebraska 37-yard line.
Talk about a turnaround. They execute the option down to the wide side of the field. Lott pitches the ball out. It looked like it was going to be underthrown from up here, but it is right there, and a great catch and a change in field position. Here's another angle from the ground level. There's the throw, and he's knocked down just at that point. He doesn't know that he completed that pass.
That Woody Shepard, that sophomore from Odessa, turned a pretty fair play there. The ball goes to Kenny King from the 37 to the 35 for two. The play was good for 48 yards. He snapped that ball just at the last second, was able to get it away, and then had to wait for the roar to see whether or not it was complete.
He took Elvis Peacock out of there, slipped Woody Shepard in there, and I guess he can throw the ball pretty good. First pass of the day and a big boomer. For the Sooners.
You didn't say that, did you?
I didn't say that.
2 minutes and 40 seconds to play in the ball game. 17-13. Nebraska leading in the ball game, and Oklahoma takes a timeout. And the clock stops at 2:37 to play in the ball game. Nebraska sitting on a 4-point lead, and Oklahoma threatening.
Is there a swifty muffler shop around here? I got the guarantee.
Nope.
What did I tell you?
He thought of all over back home.
This here ain't back home.
What do you do when you have muffler trouble?
We just mosey down to that Midas muffler shop.
What did I tell you?
You never know where you'll be when you'll need a muffler. But you do know one of our 800 Midas muffler shops will be there. Maine to California and Canada too, we're specialists. We have to do a better job.
Sooner or later, you're going to buy a recliner. And when you do, it's going to be a lazy boy. Which style? Well, that's up to you. Maybe this chair that rocks and reclines. Or this soft and comfortable contemporary. Or this wall recliner that stays 1 inch from the wall. Or a wall slow fit for two. The sooner you pick out your lazy boy, the better. Because they're all on sale right now.
Second down and 8 yards to go for Oklahoma at the Nebraska 35-yard line. 2 minutes and 37 seconds to play in the ball game. Nebraska leading 17-13. The crowd is roaring. Thomas Lott exercising the privilege of walking away from the snap, asking for a little quiet.
They also opened up the formation that time, which they haven't been doing. Split both ends out.
Yeah, but they're two tight ends. They got Victor Hicks, or is it Mathis? Mathis 86 is in. There's Hicks in, no, Rhodes is at the other side.
Yeah.
So it is Mathis from Chattanooga, Tennessee. Wide to the right side. Thomas Lott coming down the line. Gets away from the pursuit coming from the backside. That was Pullen, number 66, chasing him. And as he turned up in, then Pullen got him. Oklahoma with one timeout remaining in the ball game. 2:20, the clock is running. Hover comes in with a play. That play gained down to the 31-yard line. Here's Pillen making the tackle.
He's been in here all day. He's blocked down partially, and then gets back up and makes the play on Lott. Hangs on as Lott drives forward.
31-yard line, third down. They need three. Lott keeps it upfield. Got a first down to the 25. Pillen again on the tackle. I guess you've got to seriously consider Mr. Pillen as the defensive player of the ball game, don't you?
He's been all over the field. Oh, this is a real humdinger here. The ball's at the 25-yard line, a minute and 55. And all the marbles, you know, in this game. I think sometimes we lose sight of that. The Orange Bowl, the co-championship, Colorado waiting in the wings.
Ball is inside the 25-yard line. First down, Oklahoma. Lott wants to throw. Nope, it's going to be a reverse, and the wide receiver Rhodes is caught behind the line of scrimmage. Number 75, it looked like, was the man that penetrated. Randy Peschel for Nebraska. Back to the 30-yard line.
If you watch here closely, one of the things that happened on this split-end reverse is that the wide receiver Rhodes slips. You see him slip right there? and the timing was just off enough, otherwise he might have gotten leverage on the corner.
That's the last timeout for Oklahoma with 1:24 to go in the game.
Hi, I'm Tony Dorsett from the University of Pittsburgh. We're having an outstanding season here at the university. We're undefeated and untied. Some people say I have a good chance of winning the Heisman Trophy. But my main objective right now is to beat Penn State. And we'll see if we can do that later this evening on ABC.
Ivory's got how many yards, you say?
He's got over 100. 1 minute and 24 seconds to play in a ball game. Second down, the ball is back near the 30-yard line. They've got to go through the 14-yard line to get a first down. So it is second down at about 16 for Oklahoma. Nebraska with a six-man front. Locked back to throw. Nobody to throw to. And they get him on the 34-yard line. Ron Pruitt and Randy Fisher. Two tackles. Got him.
Big play. Big play for the Cornhuskers.
And Oklahoma does not have another timeout to spend. The clock will continue to run. Lott comes out of the ball game on third down. The football is back at the 34. It is third and 20. And Dean Blevins is the quarterback. He throws it. He hits low. He fishes it to Peacock. Peacock, first down, out of bounds. Just short of the goal line. Ah, the old police licker, how do you do?
Wow.
It's going to be first down. Goal to go for Oklahoma down on the 2-yard line with 44 seconds to play and no timeouts remaining.
This is as well executed as you could on any kind of a play. The pass is just right. The timing is just right. Peacock is right there. He deals the ball off, and here they are with the ball on the 2-yard line. But the one thing I remember is the Nebraska Cornhuskers putting on a great goal line stand against Missouri here a few weeks ago. Let's see if they can duplicate that. We're going to have to if they expect to hold on to win.
Lott is back in. No timeouts remaining. First and goal at the 2. The pitch wide. Peacock. It's touchdown. 38 seconds to play. Horace Ivory threw a sensational block to get Peacock into the end zone, and Oklahoma has regained the lead. There's only 38 seconds remaining. Incredible.
What a drive. What key plays they came up with.
84 yards, 8 plays. In 2 minutes and 52 seconds, they flipped it out to Rhodes. Blevins hit him right on the numbers, and Rhodes flipped it back to Peacock, and they got him at the 2, and then Peacock comes right back and takes it in. Wow.
Now, you can't say too much, too many good things about that drive, because they were really under pressure, the big halfback pass, and then, of course, the flea flicker were the two big plays. And, of course,
we better not forget Woodie Shepard's participation in this ball game, you know. That was a substantial play delivered.
Right.
Tonight at 9 Eastern time over most of these ABC stations. Pitt and Penn State. Oklahoma's going to absorb 5 yards here on the extra point try for taking too much time. They don't have any timeouts remaining. I don't tell you. Under the circumstances, I do believe I might just kick it. But I don't know. It looks like they're going to go for 2, doesn't it?
No, I think they're going to
No, he's out there.
He's
Von Schroman is out there. Nebraska has one timeout remaining. They'll get the ball back with about 35 or so seconds to play. Ron Sherman is out to kick. Hits it out of Hebert's hole, and he just drilled it. So, lightning strikes for the Sooners. Now, here's the pass play that got this whole thing going. Woodie Shepard throwing down. Blevins. This is the flip
Rhodes.
Back.
Yeah. Steve Rhodes, his foot receiver, came down, just curl hooked. The ball was right there, and they just deal the ball off to Peacock. You know, and the thing, that play, you've seen it many years. I've seen it operated successfully, but the key thing is the timing. Now, here's a touchdown. Lott just deals the ball off again to Peacock, and he hits the corner, and there's no way they can catch him. They're in pursuit, and he's got the leverage on it, and there's the touchdown. They're one step. There's Pillen again. He's been all over the field.
Great block over there by Horace Ivy to get him around.
So you had Woodie Shepard on a halfback pass. Then you had Blevins passing to the wide receiver Rhodes, who pitched it away to Peacock. And then you had Elvis taking it in.
They didn't pass all day, and the thing that won for them was the pass.
Two big plays defensively by Zach Henderson on Nebraska's last offensive possession. Pretty big, too. Here's a pop-up by Von Chumman. Short. It is taken by Doty Donnell, the short man. He runs it back across the 40 to the 41. Now with 34 seconds to play in the ball game, Nebraska gets the ball with one timeout remaining going into the win.
And that extra point that was made to make it 20 to 17 was very important, because had they not made that extra point, a field goal, a couple of first down plays here by Nebraska could have put them in a position for a field goal, even though they're fighting the win.
Well, you know that Bill Mallory and the Colorado Buffaloes are dancing right now. Ferragamo's running. He's just going to take it upfield, get his first down, and then take it out of bounds to stop the clock at 25 seconds to play. He got a fairly decent yardage out of that. He got it to the 42-yard line.
Good judgment. You know, you're still in a position here with another first down, a sideline pass, and even though you're fighting that wind, I don't know what the range is going to be as far as the field goal is concerned with this wind.
Well, his longest, Al Eblen's longest, was 47 yards against Colorado. We might have to have a conference vote if they should wind up tying here. I would think probably Colorado would go on to the Orange Bowl on the basis of a tie. Ferragamo to throw it. He goes, and the pass is incomplete to Melito. Pass was low, and Chuck, trying to slide along, could not scoop it up with 17 seconds remaining. Prudential College scoreboard will come up following the ball game with Warner Wolf and Dave Dials, and some details, some highlights of this ball game, looking ahead to tonight, which Pitt will be playing Penn State at 9 Eastern Time, Three River Stadium, to be seen here on ABC. Back goes Ferragamo, and he's belted by Greg Sellmeyer. He is sacked back at the 48-yard line and hurt. He really took a shot, stops the clock at 9 seconds to play in the game. And Oklahoma leading Nebraska 20-17 on a spectacular finish here in Lincoln. The defensive player of the ball game, Cletus Pillen. The linebacker for Nebraska, and in Cletus Pillen's honor will go a $1,000 scholarship award from Chevrolet to the General Scholarship Fund of the University of Nebraska. And the vote for the offensive player of the ball game, I would think, probably has to be Horace Ivory, who played a complete ball game, going for better than 100 yards today on offense and throwing the key block that sprung Peacock for the go-ahead touchdown.
There's a big load.
In, Randy Garcia. Gets the pass away down the sideline, out of bounds, time expires, and the Oklahoma Sooners have now beaten the Nebraska Cornhuskers 5 consecutive times. And congratulations to the Colorado Buffaloes. Fellas, you can pack your swimsuits and think about going to Florida.
Well, they sat back and didn't look like they were going to go to Miami Beach, but they're going to be there now. It was a great comeback, clutch passing in that last drive by the Oklahoma Sooners. It was a great, can't say too much about the comeback. I didn't think they were going to be able to do it because they had not been able to pass.
Oklahoma wins the game 20-17.